Here we are on a Friday afternoon ahead of a big holiday weekend. Labor Day, of course, coming up. And what do you know? You got a big document dump just put out there by the FBI. They released the notes from their meeting with Mrs. Clinton. And they also released about 60 pages of emails from Mrs. Clinton, many of which, as I was showing you, page after page has been redacted because apparently that information is too sensitive for anybody to actually see. Some of the headlines from that meeting that they had with her, apparently she didn't know how to actually handle classified information in any way. Nobody had actually instructed her on how to do it. She had no technical support ever traveling with her, and a variety of other things that we're going to get to in just a moment with Blake Berman. But joining me with his reaction to this news, Director of Research and Investigation for Judicial Watch, Chris Farrell, whose organization sued for the release of these emails. Chris, welcome back. Good to have you here. Obviously, a pretty important day. As I said, about 60 pages, much of which, however, we cannot see. Your thoughts on the timing of this release?
Well, it's a Friday document dump, classic Washington, D.C. style. I can tell you, I'm a former special agent of Army Counterintelligence. I've conducted national security crime investigations just like this, and I'm disappointed in the FBI's approach, based on what I've read from the 302s already. Any other federal government employee with a clearance would have been polygraphed on their statements. I think this record actually documents really kind of the disgraceful decision by the director not to go after her. And Mrs. Clinton's statements and comments in the reports, as they've been recorded, are absolutely, utterly unbelievable. There's no way in the world a woman in her position with 25 years of government experience can sit there and pretend they don't know what the portion markings see in front of a paragraph. It's insulting to the intelligence of the American people.
So you think she was saying that in order to sort of get herself off the hook, just play dumb? Oh, I don't know what's classified,
sure.
What's not classified.
Look,
nobody ever told me.
This is a very well-educated attorney, highly experienced, and this is a case of selective amnesia. It's pathetic. It is really disheartening. The segments of the reporting I've read so far are utterly unbelievable.
But in many ways, did you ever think that the Justice Department would indict her? This is the president's Justice Department. This is his FBI. If they actually go after her and indict her, they're effectively indicting themselves, are they not, Chris?
Well, with Loretta Lynch as the Attorney General, no. But that's the point for Director Comey, to really have sort of a fall on one sword moment. You know, if he's built the case and goes to the Attorney General and she says, no, I will not impanel a grand jury, then he has two choices, right? He either does the right thing and resigns or makes an issue of it, or he goes along and plays along. And in this case, Director Comey disgraced himself. He's complicit in this cover-up.
Let me ask you about another story that you guys just broke, and that's that Huma Abedin,
right,
was working to try and secure some diplomatic passports for some Clinton Foundation members. You guys discovered this via your FOIA request, and
right,
you got some emails that suggested this, in fact, was something that Huma was trying to do. You can't do that, but I'll let you explain why. In other words,
sure,
Huma would have been violating some State Department protocols by trying to secure diplomatic passports for Clinton Foundation members?
Correct. So Doug Band, Clinton Foundation director, doesn't ask, he tells Huma Abedin to get him and two other associates diplomatic passports. The fact that that occurred is outrageous. I've interviewed two diplomatic security service agent contacts of mine. I can't repeat to you what they said to me on the phone. It's unbelievable, the reaction from the professional staff in the State Department. She agrees. She says, okay. She answers back to Doug Band, okay. Doug Band admits in the second line of the email he's had diplomatic passports before. How that happened is another great question for the State Department. Nonetheless, the State Department went on the record yesterday saying, their spokesman said, President Clinton may have been given a diplomatic passport as a courtesy,
okay,
but the staff are never allowed to be given diplomatic passports.
Hey, Chris.